Before you begin, remove the access panel and processor memory duct assembly. Installation. Important. When handling the processor, do not touch the processor contacts. Important. Make careful note of the location of the pin 1 triangle on the processor, processor carrier, heatsink, and processor socket. Carefully place the pin 1 edge of the processor onto the retention clips on the pin 1 side of the processor carrier, and align the processor notch with the key on the processor carrier. Gently flex the processor carrier and place the remaining edge of the processor onto the retention clip, and again, align the processor notch with the key on the processor carrier. Inspect the notches in the processor to ensure they are properly aligned with the keys on the processor carrier. Remove the plastic shield covering the thermal pad on the secondary processor heatsink. With the pin 1 triangle on both the heatsink and processor carrier on the same corner, align the edges of the heatsink with the retention clips on the processor carrier and lower the heatsink onto the carrier. Press down firmly to secure the retention clips in the heatsink. Inspect the processor carrier retention clips to ensure that they are securely seated in the heatsink. Inspect the assembly to ensure that the pin 1 triangles on the processor, processor carrier, and heatsink are all in alignment. Inspect the processor contacts for any contamination or damage. Carefully lift the processor socket dust cover up and off of the guide pins and remove. Inspect the processor socket for any contamination or damage. With the pin 1 triangle on both the heatsink and processor socket on the same corner, align the edges of the heatsink with the guide pins on the processor socket and lower the heatsink onto the socket. Inspect the heatsink to ensure it is sitting horizontally over the processor socket. Important! The heatsink has numbers adjacent to the screw holes on the heatsink. The screws must be tightened in the sequence shown on the heatsink label, or the processor socket could be damaged. Tighten the four captive T30 Torx head screws that secure the heatsink over the processor in the sequence shown on the heatsink label. Important! Fully tighten each screw completely before proceeding to the next. Connect the heatsink fan cable into the CPU1 fan connector on the system board.